It's Friday, June 10th, and here I am, I'm at the Red Cross, and gee, you wonder, how come nothing's happening? Well, there's a situation where one of the folks that's supposed to supervise is not quite here. And today's word is age and maturity. And I want to talk to you just for a few minutes today about age and maturity. Well, right now there's a situation, it's happened before, where the nurse, the head charge nurse, as they call her, isn't showing up. And so in that case, when that happens, then everything has to wait, everything has to freeze. So we're just waiting for charge nurse to show up. Well, in my younger years, I would have freaked out, been upset. Oh my God, I'm showing, I got a right to have a, you know, but no, today, you know, I've been here before. And I have maturity, and I, at least in this situation, I'm not saying I got it all down for every situation, but in this situation, I've got this down because I've seen this happen before. And we wait around, and we smile, and guess what? Boom, the person comes, and then we're on our way. So, and the nurse, well, you want some coffee? You want to do that? I'm like, no, I'm good. And then it turned out the poor nurses that give their heart and soul, mind and strength to serve, Washington, D.C. has taken away all their chairs. So for years, I mean, as long as I can remember, at this site here in Pasadena, by the way, if you want to donate platelets, come to Cook Street and Foyle Boulevard. And we're right here. The American Red Cross is at 133 North Altadena Boulevard, Suite 103. And Rebecca is the person in charge. And they're my sponsors for today. Well, you gotta have a sponsor, you know. Now I'm just messing with you. Nobody gives me a penny. But it's nice to have a connection point. So the thing is that I've been through this before, and so I know that it's all going to work out, that they're going to bring this discharge nurse in, and that I'll be able to give. It's all going to be fine, you know. And the lady at the reception said, oh, Bobby, you know, they haven't got you. No. I'm like, you know what? Nah, it's all going to be fine. Well, age and maturity. I did the audio already on this today, and I went through some things that, you know, every single, if you don't realize this, every Devo that we do is different. Every single Devo is different. And there's not a Devo that's ever been the same. The written, the tweet, the audio, the video, everything's different. And I take a look at it from, so to get the whole big picture, or as my sister, like the vidature. I did tell you about that one time. She had this message. She's an evangelist, and she's awesome. She, and I want you to get the vidature. And I thought, what is the vidature? So finally, I remember to ask her, because I talked to her all the time. And so finally, I said, well, what is this word, the vidature? He said, well, I never said vidature. I said, well, let's look at the tape, you know. So I listened to the tape. I said, I gave the sentence exactly where it was that this happened. And, oh, that's the big picture. But with a little bit of accent she has, it sounded like the vidature to me. So, yeah, so this is funny how you just don't know, you know, you just don't know what's happening and how things go. So I am so excited today, because today's word, age and maturity, it's so critical that we as people, we've made the big lap around, now we're back. That's exercise for me today. But the thing is that age and maturity, what brought this to my mind was that my fiance, my wife, Jean, she and I are so, we feel so at one. And not just like, no, it's not just one type of love. It's a connection, it's a transparency, it's a sense of rest and peace. And it's a miracle, and we keep seeing these things in each other that are a blessing. And we're not rushing into anything. And people wonder, did you get on one knee? It's like, no, we didn't do all that, because we both just knew, oh, we're gonna, you know, our connection was so strong and so tight and so awesome that, well, we have to get married. God is the one that proposed. God is the one that did it for us. God said, you're going to be married. You know, if you guys are going to have this connection, you're going to be married, you know, because our connection is just Awesome. And I was encouraged by a couple over there at one of my church meetings I go to, and these two people walked out and we got married last Friday. Just like, you know, I've been praying for this dear one, and I kept praying and praying and praying. So what happened was all of a sudden one day we're married. I thought, wow. And that was like a really turning point. I thought, you don't have to go through this whole cultural deal. You know, she and her husband just decided we're getting married. They went and they got married, and then next week they were married. That was it. You know, and we'd seen him together, and I'd been praying for him, and she'd share that she met him and the whole thing. So that encouraged me, because I thought, well, the maturity and the grace and the strength to not have to do, well, this is the way it's got to be done. No, it isn't the way it's got to be done. We've got to be under God. We have to be official. We have to, you know, we're gonna definitely, we've already checked out the paperwork. Got to go down to, you know, I think it's City of Industry or Commerce or something, and get a piece of paper, and I got to have this other piece of paper, and there's no blood test needed anymore. Yay. So the thing is that the maturity, the ability just to rest and be secure, that isn't something that you can necessarily see in a person's physical body, because, you know, Gene's much younger than I am, and yet I feel a total levelness, and because she is much older, and her spirit and her heart and her mind are much older than what, you know, she appears. And me, I feel like I'm just now really kind of waking up. The Lord allowed this whole disaster of the last 8 years to take place. He's allowed such fiery to hit my soul and to run me through the ringer and to totally take me down, that I know that Christ is God, that God loves me. The Holy Spirit will do all things through my life. So I have an assurance, a blessed assurance, more than before. And guess what? Well, you're all done now, Bob? Yeah, you're wrapped it up? You're all ready to go? No, I'm not. I mean, I told Gene, and you'll know this too, and you ask any married couple, one of my best friends is going to celebrate 50 years of marriage in August. And so, pretty cool. But guess what? There's going to be strifes and struggles and heartaches and illness and disease and pain. Oh, you're claiming that. No, I'm not claiming. I'm just telling you life. Life is not easy. And one of the best, the favorite things I ever heard today, God bless Muhammad Ali and the family. Today, Muhammad Ali had this way of doing things. He said, act like I don't got it and just move on ahead. He just acted like nothing was wrong and he just moved on ahead. And as much as possible, that's a good thing. I remember as a young person working in a hospital back in Bible college, that the nurse told me if I had a sprain or a stress on my ankle or whatever, she says, don't favor that. Don't give it too much favor. Just try to walk it off. And that's exactly what my coach Holy Cross told me in high school. And so, yeah, you don't want to favor the weaknesses. You want to favor the strength. And still waiting for that nurse to come. We're waiting. I'm looking around, making sure the nurse comes. They're gonna cut me off here any minute. Aren't you lucky? Oh, goody. Bob's not gonna go for an hour and a half today. He's gonna have a little quick one. Jesus said that we need to love the Lord our God with all our heart, our soul, our mind, our strength, and love our neighbors ourselves. But what I'm saying is this, don't look at your neighbor's body and say, oh, he's this age. No, don't prejudge him. Get to know people, ask them questions, find out where they really are at. And I mentioned this in the audio devo, that because of the torture and the trauma and the abuse and the neglect and the horrors of growing up in the home I grew up in, and you know, my dad is still around and God bless him, he's a nice guy, but I grew up with a real, you know, my mother was just not well, and the parents were not well, and there was a lot that went on. My dad was a good guy. He had a good heart. Still does. Remember one time, I'll share it now. I guess my mom is not, you know, mom. One time my dad was told to beat the junk out of me, and so he took me in the bedroom. I remember my bed, the headboard faced north, the the footboard face to the south. I was in my room, and he said, I'm gonna hit the bed real hard, and you scream. Isn't that the crazy thing? I mean, so my dad is a good guy, but really, literally, I grew up in a time when, and this is hard for the millennials to understand, where beating and abuse and neglect was considered okay. So that took an effect on my person, on who I was. It made me, as Bob, scared. I was scared. And I talked about it in the audio. This little boy, he just is out of jail for the first time in 9 years. He confessed to a murder back when he was 14. You know, the police, their tactics, you're not going home. You're never going to see the light of day. We're going to lock you up, buddy. You're going to be fried. You better confess. And you know, if you have confessed, there's cookies and chitlins, and there's black-eyed peas, and there's some warm macaroni and cheese waiting for you, and your mom is going to give you, we'll send you right home. Just tell us what we want to know. So the kid did that. And even though a month or two later, another fella totally confessed to doing it. He said, no, I was there, the guy didn't do it. They ignored that. And it's taken 9 years of a mother's prayers and hard work to get this kid out of jail. And the point is this, young people or people that are not mature make bad choices. And those bad choices, it affects your life. And me, as a young person, I've made some really bad choices because I have a lack of maturity. And I'm much more mature now, but am I all that? No. You know, there's people that think they know everything and they don't know hardly anything. That's why if you haven't accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, it'd be a good thing to do today to stop, look up to God and say, Father, I admit, I confess that I'm a sinner. I don't have things right with you. I'm not right. Something's wrong, Lord. I can't get to you. No matter how good I am, no matter how fast I can fix a carburetor, no matter how well I can run, no matter what I can do, it's not going to get me to you, God. I need a Savior. I need a forgiver. I need someone who's paid the price, and that's Jesus Christ. So if you are accepting the Lord Jesus today, get to a Bible-believing church, read the Bible, and of course you can contact me, and I'll help guide you along as to how to start walking with the Lord. If you want to reach me, by the way, it's 213-713-8954 or 8954green at att.net, at BobBob8954 on the Twitter, and the YouTube is Pasadena Bob Devotional. Yay. I'm kind of preloading here because any minute they're going to come and whisk me away off to the secret room where I can give all my information. There's three of them that are yes, the rest are all no. I know which ones they are. I won't tell you the secret because I don't want to have them change it on me, you know. Oh, well, old Bob, he gave away our secret there. So you've been doing this for, it's now coming up on 800 times I'm going for now, and I'll beat 1,000 here pretty soon. Just consistent daily giving. And my arm has a little divot in there, and I just give, they just put the needle right in there, aren't you glad? Oh, I'm so glad that the charge nurse didn't show up. Bob didn't show us all that icky blood today. So it's not that bad. It just goes in these little sacks, and then they take the platelets, and the platelets go to cancer victims or people who are dying, people that need them. So maturity is the ability to hang in there and be stable and not panic and to believe God's word. I think that's really the key. Let's end on that. The key to maturity is not what your skin looks like, you know, and it's not what's your chronological age. I was born May 3rd. I can't even think straight anymore. It was 1936. I was born. Well, great. So you're an old guy, and you're just the maturity of a two-year-old. I mean, if you don't get your way, if things go bad, are you one to panic? Well, the thing is this, is that that's not maturity. Maturity is being able to just rest in God's word. That is the qualification. If you can trust God's word, then you're a much more mature person than can be imagined. If you cannot trust God's word, then that shows immaturity because you haven't come to a knowledge of the truth and you still think you know it all. And here's one of my favorite sayings of all time. I mean all time. I'm going to wrap up here. The people who think they know the most probably don't know very much. The wisest people in the world realize how little they know. The wisest people in the world realize how little they know. So, knowing that God is bigger than I am, I surrender, and I surrender all. I love you today. Have a fantastic day, and I'll see you tomorrow, the 11th of June. Amen.